Good evening. Good evening. Good evening.
Good evening.
How are you?
Quando riguarda e sto sforzando col denti di barba e
thank you.
You get caught in traffic? Yeah. Well, we don't want you to feel that you have missed... We don't want you to feel that you missed everything at all. See, what happened was, Zubin was standing out. We did La Gazzolata, okay? And we came to the end, and it was something like this. Where's my step? No. Just talk among yourselves for a minute while I find my way. Latecomers applaud. Meine Damen und Herren, ladies and gentlemen, this is the centenary von Grödenwölz, and we would like the honor of doing this next piece dedicated to the other man, which also was not here. This is a piece from Strauss, written in 19 for here already. You didn't even wait very long for this. Why didn't you go before you came in? This is a piece with Strauss, written in 1947. No, this was Max Strauss from Pittsburgh, and he wrote this piece, which is a lullaby, and it is called Das kleine Würdenheer. Gentle, delicate little lullaby. Das kleine Herr, haben Sie aber gehüten das Brüste gehüten. Aber das Knall haben Sie gefröden, das Ost mit der Knäll wie der Hedden. Und das Auge gezeigt mit der Ost mit der Knäll wie der Hedden. Und dann lausen Sie den Kultgeber, der wie man ist, delicate little lullaby.
I must explain something to you. The argument has been raging for years and years and years about the necessity of a conductor to begin with. And you'll find groups of people who will argue endlessly about that. The one school, a friend of mine from Great Britain, Thomas Rossiter, said, well, I don't know, actually, I suppose. I suppose you could argue both sides of the coin, I suppose. You could possibly want to do that. On the other hand, I think it's rather important to have a... I don't know, actually. I don't know what I could possibly say. You said that you were conducting a work for me. I suppose, I don't know. And the other school, which says, without the presence of a conductor, can we, within the interior, disclose the medium of the core having yet to do with the emotional disattachment involved in its progression of the instant theme. And if I am elected to this office, look, it's very easy to prove. We're going to do Ravel's Ballero, and I'll show you. Thank you. long night. I don't know about you. Right this minute, I'm having the best time I've had in years. Are you all familiar with the Nutcracker, Tchaikovsky Nutcracker Suite? Huh? Yeah. Well, we're not going to do it. No, we're going to do it if you really want to hear it, because that's very sad. I don't know. Fellas, ladies, you remember the Nutcracker Suite? You remember it? Yeah, well, we'll have to kind of fake it a little bit here, but don't let them see you turning the pages. Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky, born in Brooklyn, emigrated to Montana because there was no way he would get anywhere with a name like Tchaikovsky, and the people didn't. So he went, took a name of Bergeron and became a movie writer. Right? That's all. Now hold it. That man tried to applaud. Did you see what happened to him? He had to leave. No, I think he had an accident. Okay, you can applaud as much as you like. Have a good time. Yeah. If you're going to do it, then do it right. I mean, don't perform perfectly. Perfunctorily. Perfunctorily. I mean, if you're going to do it, let's hear it. Sound, listen. Here, you all do it with me. Look. Bop, 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 when I give you the cue. And. That's pathetic. Let me hear from this Azel over to the left. All the way up and down. Let me hear. Bop, 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 when I give you the beat. And. Let me hear this group.
A 1.5 from the high ball. This I'll you sing, ma. Everybody with me up and down and hold it real loud. We go, ma. You sing, ma. Ma. Dearly beloved.
The one I am crazy about. It absolutely destroyed me. All right, here we go. And very quiet. My fault. Serious piece. You see, they are so stunned by the way you played this so beautifully, they are all choked up. They couldn't even make a sound. Wasn't that beautiful the way they did that? Piece of music, isn't it? It's light and it's gay and it's joyful. Well, I must explain. Anybody who stands on this podium reflects their innermost secrets. They reflect their strengths, their weaknesses, their neuroticisms, all the component parts that go into making a human being. It is the greatest feeling of neurotic power in the world. It's really true. Want to see? Who's a conductor, and he just had a baby. Everything reflects itself in your everyday work, your emotional state. He has a baby, and he goes around pushing the baby carriage. He's crazy about it. And when he conducts it, it winds up the same way. Here we go. Doesn't like to lose contact with his audience. Conductor. No matter what he plays, it tears from him out his whole Grunwald. Conductor, who is slightly neurotic, and everything he does affects him in a particular way. When he gets nervous, he develops an allergy. Should have retired 100 years ago. Have you been coming to concerts for years? Yeah. Well, I tell you, I have too. And for all those years, I'm sure, you have seen nothing but the back of a conductor. Now, you must wonder how he communicates with the players. What kind of a rapport he has. What kind of an O'Leary he has, all right? And we will do the triumphal march of Aida, except I will face you, and you will see exactly what goes on in the face of a conductor. The ladies can pull their dresses away from there. And we can have a little intermission. Don't wander in. We got a lot to do, so hurry back to your seats. Hurry up! We'll see you in a minute.
They're the ones who are. Excuse me, we'll be back in a minute.
wanted you to know that I had one of those things with the long tails. But this is much more comfortable to work in. What? All right. Like my shoes, huh? Would you do me a favor, honey? All right, stand up for 1 minute and take one shoe off. Yeah, just one shoe off. That's it. Oh, she's got a big buckle. One shoe, quick. All right, now put it on the floor. Put it on the floor and stand next to it. Stand next to your shoe, dear. Okay, do you have good eyes? How do you get all of that foot into that tiny little shoe? That drives me crazy. Women used to have a kind of a grace. They used to walk. And it was a flowing kind of thing. And then platform shoes came in. Platform shoes came in, and now women all walk like they just came from a severe gynecological examination. Ladies and gentlemen, to all the men and women who use electric razors. Ladies and gentlemen, some people have greater longevity than others. We are going to do a piece by the greatest longev of all time, a fellow called Beethoven. Horace Emanuel Beethoven. Now, the reason he lived so long, because he was the longest finisher on record. Now, we have been doing a thing with Beethoven for years, and we have never finished together yet. Tonight, September 23rd, at the Avery Fisher Hall in Lincoln Center, may be the magical moment. Thank you.
In Tanglewood, they have a shed. And a great many people... Boston? Oh, do you sit in the back part of the shed? Because if you're over 40, then you have to sit in the short part of the shed. And you have to wear a sports shirt. It is really a lovely place. And I was there a couple of summers ago. And it was a rather cool afternoon. And people were sitting in the shed and they spilled over onto the grass. And in the Berkshires, the smell of new-mown grass and the trees gently waving in the very, very soft breezes was an absolute delight. And the damn flies were eating you up. We will do now the flight of the bumblebee by those two very British composers, Rimsky and Korsakov. The flight of the bumblebee. Who is the crying laugher, right in the orchestra. When everybody stops laughing, he goes, hey! In Portland, a week ago Saturday, we did a concert, and there was a machine gun laugher. Right in the middle of everything, he went, ah! People were ducking under the seats and everything. But the one I'm really crazy about is the back drafter. The back drafter, nothing comes out on the way forward. They kill themselves, they go, sat in front of a woman like that, sucked my whole scarf in. They just played an 11. This is an 11.
di-dang, ah-di-dang, ah-ra-di-yo. Ah-di-dang, go-ke-do, no-mo-kanda. Na-ri-bo-ri-go-ka-shi-ni-mu. Shi-ni-do-mu-ka-shu.
Wakaru?
That's a Korean folk song. Dozo. Dozo. Now, I guarantee you, they knew nothing about this at all. They never had any idea they were going to stand up or sing a song or anything. And she's not very nervous at all. Sho, 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 joji, sho, joji, no, ni, la, la. Well, you're singing like a baritone. Is it too high? Sho, 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 joji, sho, joji. What key do you want to sing it in? Sho.
Go.
Go. Go. Sho, 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 joji, sho, joji, no ni wa wa. Tsun, 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 ki o da mi na de te koi, koi, koi. Oi, da no to mu do cho, bo, bo, bo. Anytime you need them to do a bass roll, she can sing it for you. All right? In many, many years ago, in a conflagration that tore a European state apart many, many years ago, there was a young man incarcerated in jail. And whether he was a political prisoner or a social prisoner, or he might have just been a thief, I don't know. Anyway, he was not released from that jail for years. And in order to maintain his sanity, with his fingernails, he scratched music on the wall. Some 112 years later, when they redid this whole town and dug it up, they found this plaque. And they could tell it was a fingernail. And tonight, here with the New York Philharmonic, we want to do the 11th movement of a symphony called possible for me to continue unless there's a deathly hush in the auditorium. Serious stuff, huh?
Thank you.
I think when he's telling me afterwards won't be so pleasant.
You were looking at the film.
Yes. Oh, I have a thing. You know, everybody thinks of Beethoven, Tchaikovsky, Mahler as having very difficult passages for all the instrumentalists. Now, there's a light, supposedly, I don't know what semi-classical means, but there's supposedly a light piece of music that is as difficult to play as anything you'll find in the classics. It's called Fiddle Faddle. We are going to play it at a tempo that is virtually impossible to play. And you will hear one of the greatest virtuoso orchestras you have ever heard in your life. Your New York Philharmonic. Something, and I didn't, certainly wouldn't want you. Aldo, how are you?
Would you all like to stand up for 1 second?
Just go ahead. Just stand up and kind of, you know, do that. Come on. Father, stand up, will you? So then they'll be able to... Come on. The only red-headed Italian in New York City. All right. Yum, tum, 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 tum. Listen to the trumpet. To have a mall, and they would have Sunday afternoon concerts, and it was usually a brass band that used to play. And in the brass band, they usually had a choir of 4 trumpets and a soloist who was called the silver tongue trumpeter. Now there's a man called Del Steger, I believe, who is phenomenal, and we have a thing that I would like to do with the choir of the brass here. If you will give me a few. The soloist would sing, would play. And then the choir would play. Then they used to get to the difficult part, which was called triple tongue, and they would play. Time. and they have the same mall and the same trumpeters, but now they do a modern version of the carnival events. I'm delighted you're all here tonight. I don't know whether you know this. I suppose you have read about it somewhere. I don't know how to read music. But if you're anything like I am, oh, God, you better hope you're not, because you'd all be in a loony bin by now. I just wanted to tell you that you have done the nicest thing tonight that anybody could do. You have come here tonight and you have held out a hand in friendship and in love, and you have made it possible for all of these players, all of these musicians, all of these human beings who have devoted their lives and their energies and their love into making music for you, to bringing you joy and bringing you happiness. When the time comes for them to put down their instruments, you tonight have made it possible for them to live in some kind of comparative security. And I tell you, if more people would embrace each other and do what you are doing tonight, it would be a sweet and generous and wonderful and loving world that we would live in. Now, no, not do that. They really do a remarkable job, as do all of symphony orchestras throughout the nation. And by virtue of what you have done, when you go home tonight and you put your head on your pillow, you can smile and say, I did something nice for somebody. And you'll get up refreshed and warm and invigorated, and you have done something very, very nice by coming here tonight. Now, because we live in a crazy, miraculous, loving country, many people have come here. And when the arms of the United States were opened to people from many, many different nations, many different nationalities, many different ethnic groups, many different religious groups, they all gravitated here.
because there is basic freedom. And in this orchestra itself are people from faraway lands who have banded together in harmony to bring you music. There's one piece of music, I think, that reflects the spirit of the United States more than any other. And we'd like to play it for you now.
Thank you very much.
when I've had a better, more exhilarating, and more delightful time in my life. This orchestra is superb. They really are. My orchestra in Los Angeles is a pretty good band, too. They are all superb, and I tell you something, Zubin, you're really a remarkable fellow. You really are. And the kind of music you make with this orchestra is incredible. When you leave, one word of admonition. When you drive home, drive on the sidewalks. All the accidents are happening in the street. Good night, good luck, and God bless you.